Thanks to diamonds, most people have at least a fleeting recognition of the four C's: colour, cut, clarity, and carat weight. While the four C's are a strong foundation in determining a gemstone's final value, there are two other factors that also need to be considered when purchasing coloured gemstones, namely country and confidence. This quick video introduces you to the six C's. More detailed information can be found on our website here, or by subscribing to our YouTube channel here. Okay, so colour is the single most important factor when assessing gemstones and contributes to about 50% of a gem's final value. Colour can be a great way to pick the right gem for you, but like everything to do with beauty, it's in the eye of the beholder. The gemstone colour scale goes from D, being the perfect colourless gemstone, to Z, which would mean there is a significant colour change. Whilst it would be wonderful if gemstones came out of the ground ready to wear, this simply doesn't happen. Raw crystals from the earth are called rough gemstones. They're already thousands of years old. Cutting the gemstone, a profession called lapidary, is the transformation of raw crystals into dazzling gemstones by making the gem assume a certain shape. It's called faceting, thereby unlocking its luster, color, and its brilliance. Many shapes are possible, from the circles you see with diamonds, to pearl shapes, to squares, or even cabochons, which are round or oval smooth surfaces. You will have seen those when you've been looking at an opal. So, most gemstones are comprised of a single crystal, but regardless of their structure, very few gemstones grow in nature undisturbed. The process of gemstone formation is often cataclysmic, resulting in tiny natural imperfections called inclusions. So similar to knots in a wooden table, these natural characteristics record a gem's relationship with the earth over the thousands of years. So carat weight, coming in as the fourth C, carat weight is the physical size of the gemstone, and this really matters. All things being equal, the bigger the gem, the higher the value. This is because colour is more visible in larger gemstones. So gemstones are traditionally weighed in carats, but don't confuse this with gold, whose purity is measured in carats. That's with a K. They both derive their name from days gone by when carob seeds were used as a counterbalance. Therefore, 1 carat equals 0.2 grams or 200 milligrams. For gemstones weighing less than a carat, their weight is expressed in units that are 100 times smaller, known as points. So like a British pound, so pounds and pence, 0.75 of a carat equals 75 points, and so on. The country of origin never denotes quality, as good and bad quality gems are found in every deposit. But some sources are noted for producing better quality gems than others. For this reason, it's really important to understand the four C's. So if you're buying an expensive gemstone and you're being told it's from a highly prestigious mining region, it's good to actually know that these types of gems are in fact mined there. So the sixth and final C is the confidence that comes from knowing your gems are from legitimate mining sources. And the mining and the faceting of your much admired gemstone was not born through any kind of conflict or oppression in the region that it derived from. So remember, to sound and act like a gem expert, it's all about knowing your colour, your cut, your carat, and your clarity, and then taking into consideration country and confidence.